Hi, I'm Jen Roberts, and today I'm going to be sharing with you three tips to help prepare you for the patient-driven payment model. We are getting close to that October 1st date, my friends, and we are all in the same boat. I'm going to be releasing videos to help you prepare and just share tips. Always remember to check with your RAI manual and CMS for the guidelines for coding as they may change. My first tip on the patient-driven payment model is trying to utilize dual monitors. So instead of having one monitor where you're completing all of the information just on the one screen, maybe you try to minimize and maximize that window. What I'm suggesting is maybe adding a complete new monitor. So these monitors hook up very easily and you can plug those in to your current computer tower, and then you'll have two monitors. So it's an extension of your desktop, but that means you can have an application open on this screen and an application open on the other screen. So you're not spending so much time going back and forth. I find it very helpful even for care planning purposes. So I can have all of the residents' orders up on one page and ensure that I'm care planning the appropriate items. So that first recommendation, again, the dual monitor will save you time. My second tip is to think about your OBRA schedule. Do you have any assessments that you can push forward? So always remembering that the OBRA schedule is not changing and you're going to need an assessment every 92 days. And also your annual requirements, you must have an annual every 366 days. So you want to make sure you follow the guidelines, but can you move any up or maybe even push some back? The reason for that is you're going to really want to focus on the patient-driven payment model in that first week of October. Every Medicare resident who is in your facility will be required to have a transitional intermittent payment assessment completed. So you want to try and eliminate any of those extra assessments that we can. So if any can be pushed forward, my tip is to push those forward. My third and final tip for this week is to consider developing a plan for those transitional intermittent payment assessments. We're only going to have the transitional IPAs for the first 7 days of October. So day one through day seven, you can set your assessment reference date. It doesn't have to all be on the same day. So if you have a high number of Medicare, let's say you have 15 Medicare assessments, you may want to say residents who have the last name of that begins in an A and ends in a K. I want to have their ARD on 10-3. And then the residents who have the last name that starts with L and goes to Q, you could complete their ARDs on 10-6. So consider making a system, a process, so you know when you're going to complete an assessment for your residents and your IDT understands as well. Because remember, this needs to be an interdisciplinary team process. So sharing with them your plans for the scheduling and making sure you have a process to keep you on track, because you want to ensure you capture a true clinical picture of your residents. Thanks for joining me today. I hope you were able to pick up a few helpful tips. Make sure and hit that subscribe button. And as always, I hope you have an amazing day, and thanks for learning with Jen.